Now in this video, we'll solve some questions using polar equations of conic sections. In one of the previous videos, we have discussed polar equations of conic section. I'll provide the link to that video in the description below. And we have studied that polar equation of any general conic is given by R equals L upon 1 minus E cos theta, where R is focal radius, which is distance from focus, and theta is angle that it makes with the axis, and here L is semilatus rectum, and which in the case of parabola will be 2a, and we also know eccentricity in the case of parabola is simply 1. Now using this polar equation, we'll prove that the sum of the reciprocals of the segments of any focal chord is constant. So suppose we have any general conic. It may be ellipse, hyperbola or parabola. And then we have a chord which passes through its focus. Now say this is R1 and it is R2. We need to show that the sum of reciprocals of segments of any focal chord. So that means we need to prove that 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2, it is constant. We know that equation of any general conic is R equals L upon 1 minus E cos theta. So if we'll take this angle as theta, we can write R1 as L upon 1 minus E cos theta. And we can rearrange it as 1 upon R1 equals 1 minus E cos theta upon L. Now we know that for this point, value of R will be R2, and angle in this case will be theta plus pi. So we can write R2 as L upon 1 minus E cos pi plus theta. Now cos pi plus theta is minus cos theta. So we can write R2 as L upon 1 plus E cos theta. And we'll rearrange again. We'll write 1 upon R2 as 1 plus E cos theta upon L. Now we'll add these two equations. So we'll add them. We can write 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. Now here E cos theta and E cos theta will cancel. We'll get 2 upon L. And we can write this as 2 R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2 is equal to L, which is semilatus rectum. So if we'll recall the condition in parabola, that harmonic mean of segments of focal chord is equal to semilatus rectum. So that result, it is not just true for parabola, it is true for any conic section for parabola, ellipse and hyperbola. Now we'll prove the second result, which is the sum of reciprocals of two perpendicular focal chords is constant. So now we have two perpendicular focal chords. So we have any conic section and then we have two perpendicular focal chords. And say this is S. Now say this is P and P dash, and suppose it is Q and Q dash, and say this angle is theta. Now say this is R1, R2 and this is R3 and R4. Now we can write R1 as L upon 1 minus E cos theta, and for R2 we can write R2 as L upon, now for this one angle will be theta plus pi, so it will be 1 plus E cos theta. So we'll find this length PP dash. So PP dash is simply R1 plus R2. So it'll simply be L, we'll take common, and then we'll have this LCM, which is 1 minus E square cos square theta, and then we'll also have 2. So it'll simply be 2L upon 1 minus E square cos square theta. Now in the same way, we'll find this q and q dash. Now for this q, we'll write r3 as l upon 1 minus e. Now what about this angle? Now this angle will be theta plus pi by 2. So cos pi by 2 plus theta is minus sine theta. So it'll be 1 plus e sine theta. And r4, it will be l and 1 minus e sine theta. Now we'll add them, we'll get q q dash. So it'll be simply r3 plus r4. In this case, it'll be 2l upon 1 minus e square sine square theta. Now it says we need to find sum of reciprocals of two perpendicular focal chords. So we'll need to find 1 upon pp dash plus 1 upon q q dash. So 1 upon pp dash plus 1 upon q q dash, it will be 1 minus e square cos square theta upon 2l plus 1 minus e square sine square theta upon 2l. So it will be 2 minus, now sine square theta plus cos square theta will be 1. So it will be 2 minus e square upon 2l, and which again is independent of theta. So that means sum of reciprocals of two perpendicular focal chords is also constant.